Well, with me is John Hemmings, Director of the Asia Studies Centre at the Henry Jackson Society and Adjunct Fellow at the Centre for Strategic and International Studies. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks.
Do you think Donald Trump is capable of bringing about some historic solution here?
Do you know, a year ago I probably would have said no, and I think I'm rapidly, as we all are, shifting my position on the man. His communication style has a lot to be asked of it, but he can turn very quickly. His diplomacy is very agile. Now, some people have criticized that as being, you know, he has no strategy, but I think he reacts very quickly to events, much quicker than we've had in previous administrations. So I'm more hopeful, but still cautious.
The US obviously wants denuclearization. What does North Korea want from this?
So there's probably about three things they want. I mean, initially, people always say they want survival of the regime, but that's at the low basis. I mean, they also want success of the regime. You know, they want prosperity. I think they would, if you go further, they would also like to see unification at some point. That still plays very largely between the regime and the military as a strong kind of a driver. And then the third one would be, and this is, I think, where it starts to run into U.S. foreign policy geostrategic objectives, they'd like to see a diminishment or removal of U.S. troops from the peninsula. So
how would unification work, though, given the vast political gulf between North and South?
I mean, luckily for us, this summit is not about unification. This summit is really just about denuclearization and peace. The unification issue, the main stop for it is the fact that South Korea's youth are just disenchanted. They're not looking to the North as a kind of, you know, for unification in very large terms. So whatever happens in unification terms, you'd want to see that going forward, something that the North and South would decide themselves, but with the obvious caveat that China and the US will kind of be in the wings.
So Donald Trump announcing that, you know, if he doesn't like what's happening, he won't meet Kim, or he will just walk out of the meeting. That's typical Trump tactics, perhaps. But there are presumably a lot of people behind the scenes now trying ferociously hard to make this happen.
Absolutely. The Pompeo visit, I think, shocked us all, as did the, you know, involvement in the Olympic summit. It was so quick, and it came right after the kind of rocket man, dotard, you know, Twitter war.
Well, what role will China play? Will they give a sort of guarantor or guarantee of support to the North? Is that what
ideally?
Principal key?
Yes, that is the key. I mean, this is something that we've long wanted China to offer the North, which is that kind of nuclear umbrella that the U.S. has likewise offered its own allies when they were asked to denuclearize. So South Korea actually had its own nuclear program back in, I think it was the 70s. And at that time, that was when the U.S. said, you know, we will extend the nuclear umbrella over you, you are covered, but you have to get rid of this program. So if the Chinese can offer that deal, I think we could go forward towards some sort of negotiational, you know, resolution.
It's going to be a fascinating few weeks. John Hemmings, thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.